In the next animation, what we're going to do is focus on one of these matrix multiply with blocks, and we're going to examine all of the computations that are required to update all of the elements in that block of C. And let's have a look at that, and then we'll come back and look at what conclusions we can draw from that.
So what we've done here is we've zoomed in on the three blocks, one from C, one from A, and one from B, that have been quote-unquote placed in the cache. And we're now going to carefully look at what computations are being done with the microtiles of C and the micropanels of A and B, and keep an eye on how they are reused in subsequent computation. So we update the first microtile of C, and for that we need the first micropanel of A and the first micropanel of B. If we then go to the next microtile in the first column of C, then we will use a different micropanel of A, but the same micropanel of B. And you're starting to see the pattern. Okay, then we move on to the next column of microtiles, and that means that we're starting to use the next micropanel of B, but we reuse the same micropanels of A again. And we move on. And we move on. If we focus on the first microtile, what we notice that when updating microtiles of this block of C, those microtiles, once updated, are not reused again. So what that means is that we don't need to keep the entire block of C in the cache. We can instead simply keep the microtile of C in cache until it's done being updated, and then we can evict it. Now, once we're done updating all of the microtiles in the first column of matrix C, we notice that we don't reuse the micropanel of B again. So what that means is that we really only need to keep the micropanel of B in the cache as long as it is needed to update the current column of microtiles of C. Now, let's look carefully at how the micropanels of A are used and reused. What we notice is that those are reused many times, and therefore we would like to keep that entire block of A in the cache as long as possible so that we get lots of reuse of that data.
So what we noticed is that we really should think of partitioning the block down here and down here. And then we notice that we don't need to have the entire block of B resident in this cache layer, because once we have multiplied it with all of these micropanels of A to update all of these microtiles of C, we will not be reusing it. So really the picture should look more like this. And we also notice that at any given time, we really only need to worry about having one of these microtiles sitting in the cache, because once you've updated it, you don't need to bring it back in the future. So really the picture looks more like this. So why is this important? This is important because if we need to store less of C and less of B in the cache, then we can store more of A in the cache. That means that the block sizes that we have created here can be bigger. And if those block sizes can be bigger, then we amortize the cost of moving data from main memory into the cache over more computation. That B in the discussion in the last unit becomes bigger, and therefore we should be able to attain better performance.